It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Houston Texans and the Baltimore Ravens. All that and more coming up next.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Today we've got a fun AFC matchup on tap as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Baltimore Ravens. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Now, Charles, you and I, we've done a lot of games together. Always seems like we're rehashing the same storylines. Turnovers, of course, always a big story. Quarterback play, running backs, yada, yada, yada. But getting ready for this one word kept coming to mind, and that's preparation.
Well, it's critical to be prepared physically, mentally. When you think about getting ready for an NFL game, you have to wonder, what will they throw at us that maybe we haven't seen before? 2-minute drill, maybe different things like that. Got to be prepared. You're exactly right.
Here's the former UCLA Bruin, Kaimi Fairbairn, to get this one started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. The Ravens offense going to work, and as usual, it's Lamar Jackson, the former MVP of the league, at the helm.
And he remains the league's premier rushing threat and one of the biggest playmakers among quarterbacks. His goal each and every season, continue to expand his game as a passer and become well-rounded. All those highlight reel plays you see, they come off the fact that he can run it, throw it, and scares defenses every time he takes a snap.
Real quick.
Jackson, first play, going to throw. A short one there, caught by Likely. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. First carry now for Justice Hill. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. And they'll look to avoid an early 3-and-out here on 3rd and 4. Jackson now. And he will not be able to hang on to the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
Now on 4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Singletary to get the drive started, and he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. The drive starting with a 1st down, 11 yards on that pickup.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Stroud. He'll get this into the hands of Nico Collins. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. From the 43, here's 2nd and a couple. Singletary here running out of the gun. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Not too many more ideal situations in second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Stroud to the air on first and 10. Going quickly there, but it's incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Now a second and 10. Stroud to throw it. He gets this one to Metchie. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
Over the middle, he gets it to Collins. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that. Moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, grab that dagger play, grab that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
Oh, I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Stroud will look to throw once more, and he's unable to haul it in. So it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up 4th.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. It's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to be taken down. Remember, he needed 4 yards, and 4 yards is going to be what he gets as they do convert here on 4th down. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on 4th. Here's 1st and 10. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. Defense able to get there. Swarm to the football. Zilch, 0, nada there for the offense, Charles.
Yeah, it really was an example of good team defense, wasn't it? Everyone handled their responsibilities, and they held them to no gain.
Here's 2nd and 10. Throwing now is Stroud. He'll complete this one to Collins. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his 3rd completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Had a chance to maybe limit them to 3 if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right now, everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defenses just say, okay, new set of downs. It gives us another chance to make a play ourselves and maybe change things up.
The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a 2nd and long.
I really like the angles that the tacklers came from on that play. They secured inside, took away the cutback. The sideline's there, so he can only go so far outside, and they were able to close in and tackle him for a loss.
Yeah, they use your boy over there, the 12th man. Sammy sideline, right?
Sammy sideline. You know something? He tackles pretty well, too.
He's tougher than an airport steak. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Stroud on third down now. And the ball is knocked out, and it's picked up by the Ravens. Well, that's unfortunate because he had a nice run going, but give credit to the defense. They got a hand in the cookie jar there, CD.
You have to think about vision, finding a place to get down after you know you've gotten all you can out of a run. And obviously, ball security is paramount. In today's football, everyone's coming after the rock. You've got to make sure you protect it and protect the yardage you just gained.
Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. No score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Off the option, here's Edwards. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
And now Jackson will look to throw it.
A short one there, caught by Likely.
Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the broken tackle. They'll give him 4 yards there, and it's second down.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
On second down, it's Edwards. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 42 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times.
Well, if they continue to run the football this strong right up the middle, I don't know if they can wait till halftime to make adjustments. They better find a way to get it done series to series. I don't know if they need to sub some guys out, bring in extra people, maybe change what they're doing on the defensive side of the ball. But right now, they're running the ball very well right at them and right up the middle.
So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to bring up second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch. But even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss. But that window closed quickly. On second down, here's Jackson. His throw incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Here comes the 8th play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Here's Jackson to throw. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. So look at this. Here's the field goal unit coming out. And he is going to need to bomb this one.
They spot it on the midfield stripe. So it is a 60-yard attempt here. And that is no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Well, he might be the best kicker the game's ever seen. And we've seen him hit from 66, which is the all-time record. But anything 60-plus, that's a very low percentage kick. Don't tell him. He doesn't believe it. But this one winds up no good.
So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Stroud looking to throw. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And the Ravens are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
What did you see on that one? Rookie mistake or just good defense?
It was a combo plate, but the rookie quarterback, he'll take it all on his shoulders, and the frustration level is evident. You can see it with him. You know, if that's a veteran quarterback, he walks off like he just threw a touchdown pass because he doesn't want to show that to the defense. The young guys, they take it more to heart. It's on their sleeve a little bit. He'll learn as he goes along how to hide his emotions.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. They'll run with Edwards here to begin the drive. And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry.
It'd be hard to say that a defense wouldn't be ready for a first down run. And when you can gain that kind of yardage against a defense that's really kind of geared to stop that play, your confidence has to rise. And now you've actually opened up your playbook. If you want to throw the ball now for play action, you're good to go.
To throw is Jackson. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
On third down, Jackson. This complete left side to Aguilar. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches.
Well, it wasn't a big strike. But that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
Tucker's kick is good. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0. Well, they got the turnover in great field position, but unable to do anything with it. And they're left taking the easy three on the field goal.
Yeah, you're right about that. A great chance at a short field touchdown. On a sudden change, you take the ball away, you expect your offense to put into the end zone, but they'll take the three for now, even if they feel just a little bit let down.
Tucker now following the main field goal, set to kick it away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
Houston's offense taking over again.
And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
It was Jadeveon Clowney who got upfield for the stop.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. They go right back to Singletary. Fights off the defender. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker on a defender, and then the running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
And meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 45 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. And Stroud now to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down because they did not want to give the ball up here late in the half. They'd love to take the clock all the way down and score. This will definitely help the cause.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now Stroud. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Patrick Queen got in there to stick him. He gets the sack. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
Here's Stroud. And that's going to be incomplete.
Well, congratulations to them. They come through defensively with another stop. And let's face it, this secondary, they've gone unchallenged so far in the first half.
A long way to go here on 3rd down for the 8th play of the drive. On the handoff, running left, Singletary. And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a 4th down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Now on 4th down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. Gus Edwards heading back onto the field. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals. Final 24 seconds of the first half as they come up here 1st and 10. Now it's Jackson.
A short one there, caught by Likely.
So the completion good for just 3. And that will bring up 2nd down. And this time, they'll just keep this on the ground. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we're at halftime here in the Inner Harbor with the hometown Ravens on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Coach. If you missed the first half, there's not much to get you caught up on. Just the lone field goal accounting for the entirety of the scoring. A 3-0 game to this point, as both defenses have been strong so far.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter.
They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
And they'll throw it with Stroud here, first and 10. We'll get this to Devin Singletary out of the backfield. And he is going to lose yardage here. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play design was.
Back to throw. Here's Stroud. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. And he'll be out right at the 35. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
And he's got Jordan complete right side. And he is going to have a Texans first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on third and inches.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains, because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
He had to fight that time. Ran through one tackle, but ultimately he's only going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
On the bootleg, Stroud. This will be complete to Mechie. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll leave him with a third and just a yard. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. 70 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? They looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Ball on the 27. Here's second down and 2. from the shotgun. He'll look to throw.
That'll be caught left side by Woods.
He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
First and 10, it's Stroud. And this will be incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game, second and 10. Singletary, they'll go up the middle. There's a nice move. And he'll be out of bounds. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. They had a chance to limit his yardage, but he was able to fight off that tackle.
So it's not just the responsibility of the guys who missed the tackles along the way. It's all 11 on defense, able to stop this guy, unable to do it on that play. They've got to find a way. How about his ability to break through and gain that yardage?
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. Singletary. Oh, he's going absolutely nowhere as he is hit behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
Now they'll put a receiver in motion left. Singletary again, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3 yard line. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to it.
And he's in for the score. Touchdown, Texans. Devin Singletary, a 3 yard touchdown run. And the Texans have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Hard to argue with that being their best drive of the game so far as they use the running game to get them into the end zone.
Couldn't agree more, partner. Prior to that drive, they sputtered a little bit, but it looks like they found the formula. I would expect them to go back to that more and more as this game develops.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. Returning it, Justice Hill. The return man is Hill. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half.
And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one-score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw caught by Kohler.
So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
On second down, here's the option.
Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
So it's the big left tackle who gets tagged with a hold.
And sometimes you're actually executing the block well and he starts to slip off of you, and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And when it's done like that, it's often seen by the official and called.
Now Jackson on second down.
A short one there, caught by Likely.
And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line.
That was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
Third and 12.
Off the draw, here's Hill. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. 7 yards on the carry there, but now they're staring at fourth down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Ravens with possession of the football, but trailing on the big board as we get set for the fourth. A 42-yard punt, three on the return.
And the Texans will take over.
Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
112 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, you know me, partner. I never tell him to back off of being aggressive. But sometimes you see the consequences when you're overly aggressive and you don't secure tackles. Guys break through.
Trying to sell out to pry that football loose. And just as you said, cost some yardage.
Yeah, you got to go get him. Stand him up first before you go for the ball. Don't just go for it initially.
And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46.
Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty.
Stroud to throw it.
And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
I like how he hung in there and went through his progressions, but eventually his internal clock went off and told him it was time to make a run for it, and he ends up sliding down with a solid gain.
38-yard line, second and 11. Stroud working out of the gun. He'll try and fire this downfield for Singletary. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
Oh, man, late in a tight ball game, every play so critical, you feel like you've got to find a way to come up with that football. That was put in a great spot, but it just didn't want to stick in his hands. That's a big letdown.
Stroud.
And that's incomplete.
Decision.
Here's Cameron Johnston now as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is taken at the 15. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field.
Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
They'll start with the option.
And they're able to get this one across.
across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
First play of the drive. Excellent run. Just sets up wash, rinse, repeat. Another first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Jackson going to give this one to Edwards. Shedding the tackle. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Second down and 4.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. Christian Harris. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Now after that sack, it's 3rd and long for Jackson and the Ravens. This is Hill on the draw play. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And the Texans will take over with a 1st and 10. Now let's spotlight Devin Singletary as this offense comes back out.
He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's come together for you. Big guys up front have created space. You've run through it. You've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. That'll be a pickup of 4 as they work with this 4-point fourth quarter lead. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on 2nd down.
Throwing now is Stroud.
And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield.
The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss. But found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. Back to throw, Stroud. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Jadeveon Clowney showing the explosiveness on the sack.
If an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They're looking at a 4th down now as they try to hold on to this lead for dear life. Here's Cameron Johnston now, and you wonder, could they possibly think about taking a safety here? And he's able to get it out of there. And a fair catch called for and taken right on the midfield stripe. Jackson and the Ravens, here they come. Down 7-3, 1:55 remaining. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on 1st down.
DC, ready?
Jackson.
That's out to Hill, right side complete.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here's a second and 7.
And he'll get this down only to about the 46.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk-reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
Here now, 3rd down. Now Jackson. He'll let it go deep for Beckham.
And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
Well, that's an aggressive shot to take. They definitely need a touchdown, but now you paint yourself into a corner because it's 4th down. And if you don't get a conversion here, that could be the end of the comeback.
Here we go, it's Jackson on 4th down. And it's going to be batted down, and we'll go the other way with the football.
They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and this Texans defense stands tall.
No surprise, they try to throw the ball on 4th down, but it gets batted down. They don't pick it up.
Well, a little football 101. When you're going toward that quarterback, you see he's going to start to throw. Get your hands up,
get
right?
Get your hands up, affect the play, and then everyone, get your hands up. When the ball gets to the receiver, moment of truth, knock it away.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 46. They'll start this drive out on the ground.
And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be 2nd down.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
The Ravens going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
Two yards still to go. 3rd down now. Here's Stroud.
And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away. The offense for the Ravens returns to the field. This game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
This is 1st and 10.
Here's Jackson.
And his throw here is incomplete. Well, these corners, I tell you, they've done excellent work all game long.
They remind me of guys in the past who just said, hey, throw it out here 100 times, nothing good is going to happen. And if you throw it in the wrong place, I'll take it the other way.
Just over 30 seconds remain. Here's 2nd and 10 now. Jackson.
It throws it on the move, but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Throwing, Jackson. And he takes this almost to midfield. So they needed a pretty good size play and they got it.
This offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down.
Jackson to throw.
He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Similar to a shooter in basketball who just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now we had a guy who made the catch. They try to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
Another try, second and 10 now.
Now Jackson. That'll be caught by Hill. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 41-yard line.
That was a long shot, but they did get one final chance to try to score and overcome this small deficit. No touchdown, though, Charles. And that brings this one to a close.
Yeah, I think hope was wearing one jersey and worry was wearing another on the other sideline as that final snap played out. Now, we've seen some incredible plays to win games before, but in this case, I think the distance was just a little bit too great for it to happen here.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. From Baltimore, so long, everybody.